Mara Davidson.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The Greens will be absolutely supporting the minimum wage contractor remuneration amendment bill. And I will pick up from where my colleague Chris Hipkins just left the end of his debate. Because this is actually about bringing our society up to one that is fairer and that is more cohesive, and one, you know, because the thing is, the low wage society, which is what this government supports and believes in, has just done us in badly. And we're seeing the ugly rearing head of it right now. So this is why just today, the low-wage economy, and which is why this government is opposing this bill, they're making up all sorts of excuses and reasons. They even tried to say to us that we support the principle of the bill, but it's a messy bill. That is an absolute excuse. And again, I have to say, I've been sitting here feeling, just trying to keep my language parliamentary, vomitous about us sitting here, us here on the salaries that we're all on and more, us sitting here having the cheek, having the absolute cheek to even fight against a minimum wage. What is it? $15.25. We're going to deny New Zealanders $15.25. We're going to deny contractors a bit of legislation to bring them up to $15.25, us here in this house, us here sitting on these salaries. I have felt vomitous about that. I'm going to use that word. It is feeling really disconnected, quite abhorrent actually, that we can even have the cheek to stand in this house and argue against the Schedule 2 of this bill, which is about bringing the rate of remuneration not to be less than minimum rate of $15.25. Wow, go us. Go us in here. Go us in here. Okay, I'll get back to the bill. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Okay, so the government cries of opposing this bill have been that it's impractical, that it's not going to do what it's intended to do. They are doing that under the guise of being sympathetic with the intent. Thankfully, none of us are going to fall for it. None of us, and New Zealanders aren't going to fall for it. Do you know what happened today? Research released today from Otago University showed that more than half of all homeless New Zealanders are working or studying. I am going to ask that we research how many of those workers are on any sort of contract. And according to Schedule 2, that means that I'm going to ask how many of our building and construction services, cleaning services, courier services, food catering services, all of those listed in Schedule 2, I'm going to ask that we research how many of those contractors are struggling, are in any sort of insecure housing situation, which is what the report is showing, that, you know, half are. So I'll move on from there. We are also supporting this bill, as I said, because it is one step, thank you, Honourable, it is one step towards fixing what this government has neglected in terms of inequality increasing. So we will be supporting this bill. We'll be trying to support workers and support and reduce the inequality that has been worsening under this government. So you know what it actually is, this is the thing. This bill is to help stop us stealing less from workers, from people who work, from contractors. This bill is to stop us from stealing the money that we steal off contractors by paying them a little bit more towards what they are worth. That's what this type of legislation is actually about. It's not about giving people who contract more. It's about stealing less, because they deserve that, they need that to live a good life, and then some. So that's also what this bill is about. My colleague Catherine Delahunty is going to go into more detail around. Here is Mr. Chair, please.
Dr. Mr. Jane Chair. Young.